And then we start driving and I can see the street. I can see the street.
The Australian Barbecue Supreme. The Australian Barbecue Supreme.
Post-traumatic stress.
Many people are curious as to why they sometimes hear a sh sound at the start of words like strong and street. Some people are strangely distressed and distraught about it. Now, what's behind this is something far more widespread, but much less noticed. And it's something that's really just making English simpler. So let's get into that right now. The key factor we're interested in is English R. In languages around the world, R is often a tap of the tongue tip just behind the upper front teeth, ara, ara, or a series of taps that we call a trill, rrr. But English R turns things upside down. Literally upside down from the perspective of the International Phonetic Alphabet, because this is actually the precise symbol for English R. And we can add an extra topping to show that it's often made with the lips rounded.
Recently.
Really fast.
Really.
And then rapidly.
Ridiculous.
So English R, in most accents at least, doesn't have that contact made by the tip of the tongue, but it does have the tongue pulled back into one of various shapes that give the distinctive R sound. What these shapes have in common is their location near the region of the palate we call post-alveolar. Americans generally pronounce it post-alveolar. And here's the thing. This is the same general area where we make English sh. In fact, not just sh, but a group of sounds including ch and j, as in shed, check, Jeff. These can be written in various ways. Sh, ch, j, or more simply, sh, ch, j. So we can refer to all these sounds, including English R, as post-alveolar. They also share the tendency for rounded lips. Compare the alveolar S, T and D. Now note that English has plenty of words where SH and R form a cluster, like at the start of shrimp, shrink, shred, shrub, etc. But English has no words beginning S, R. No, shrimp, shrink, shred, shrub, etc. In fact, when English speakers see words starting SR like these, they generally just pronounce them as though they were written SHR, which happens to be fairly accurate for the former, but not the latter.
Sri Lanka's politicians.
The Sri Lankan Prime Minister.
Sri Lanka's Prime Minister. Sri Lanka's President.
Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka.
In Srebrenica.
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 We English speakers are more comfortable keeping the whole cluster post-alveolar. We'd rather not have to slide the tongue quickly from S to R. So what about TR and DR? We have loads of words where the tongue has to slide quickly from T and D to R, right? Try, dry, trip, drip. Well, not really. If you pay close attention to the way I say trip and drip, you'll notice that I'm changing the T and D, pulling them back to match the following R. Compare the T and D in tip and dip. Tip, t, 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 trip, ch, dip, drip, ch. And here's the really interesting thing. Millions of speakers on both sides of the Atlantic have taken words like try and dry, trip and drip, train and drain, and gone a stage further, actually replacing the T and D with CH and J. I'm going to call this train changing and drum majoring. Note that the R stays right where it is. Train does not become chain. It becomes train. And drum does not become jum. It becomes drum. One place where you can read about this is in my book, where I have a whole chapter on it. And you can find it nicely described by some YouTubers. Josh at English Hacks sums up the situation perfectly.
Some speakers will use a T and a D plus the R. They'll say tur or dur. But many speakers will either also or instead use chur and jur. They'll change the T into a CH and a D into a J, like the J sound. And this is how I speak, and that's what I recommend. Train, trip, drain, drip.
And there's no doubt that younger native speakers in general are saying and hearing words like this in exactly this way, including small children who haven't yet learned the conventional spellings.
I wanted to share with you this little writing sample from my 7-year-old son. He writes, "Watch out for the storm trooper." Yes, he's hearing a CH there, just like you are.
We also have reports of kids playing the I Spy game. For example, I spy with my little eye something beginning with ch. Could it be chair? Chicken? No, train. And adults in various parts of the English-speaking world report that they do the same. Let me know in the comments if you've encountered children, or adults for that matter, writing chr and even dr for words conventionally written tr and dr. Now, there's a clear advantage if we follow Josh in teaching the pronunciations with train changing and drum majoring, because it's a much easier way for learners to sound more native than trying to make my kind of retracted t and d. Pronunciations like this look strange to learners and to natives when they're written down, but they sound fine, almost indistinguishable from the older kind of pronunciation used by folks like me, which of course is how they arose in the first place. Infants acquiring native English heard retracted t and d like mine from the grown-ups around them and decided, unconsciously of course, that what they were actually hearing was ch and j. This is one of the ways that language change happens. Now, what the younger generations have achieved with this train changing and drum majoring is actually to tidy up English word structure. As we saw before, older speakers like me have shr but no sr. On the other hand, we have tr and dr but not chr and dr. But the young train changers and drum majors simply have shr and chr and dr. This may not match the spelling, but it's phonetically what scientists would call more elegant. All the clusters are completely post-alveolar. Except there's still one cluster that's messing things up by starting alveolar and ending post-alveolar. It's the one in strong and street. Now, what would be really scientifically elegant is if speakers could make that one completely post-alveolar.
And then we start driving and I can see the street, the pavement passing. I can see the street, the street.
I'm going to call this one street shopping. Speakers like Michelle Obama have a complete set. Train changing, drum majoring, and street shopping. Shrimp, train, drum. Street. They've eliminated tr, dr and str in the same way that none of us has sr. And research indicates that all the speakers who do street shopping, like Michelle Obama, also do train changing and drum majoring, like Josh. So street and strong are just a logical extension from pronunciations like Sri Lanka and Srebrenica. And of course it's not just Michelle Obama. Street shopping is not as widespread as train changing and drum majoring, not yet anyway, but it's well established in some accents and seems to be increasing in others.
Astronomers, teams of astronomers, astronomy, astronomers, puzzling over a strange, distributed, extremely catastrophic, destroyed, more strongly destroyed.
You can't rush Australia. So savour the Australian barbecue supreme. Australian barbecue supreme.
Strength is very important in terms of showing elements of strong strength.
Yeah.
Strong strength.
Yeah.
As you increase a person's level of stress from not stressful to slightly stressful, and then extremely stressful, its activity gets stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger.
Now, I'd love it if all you native speakers around the world could help me find out more about which accents and age groups have train changing, drum majoring, and even street shopping, and in what types of words. So I've put a survey on my website that should take you less than 5 minutes to complete. It'll help us to update the online dictionary that I co-edit, and I'll report the results in a future video. So if you're a native, please do give it a go. Meanwhile, if you want to know why street should probably be written street or street, then this is the video to watch next.